to here, or basically you're filling up to here. To here.
Oh, up to here. Okay.
So that would be 11 gallons. Right here says no chemical.
Okay.
Okay. So if you want to use chemical, I brought you a sample of some super jets that are pretty good in the container that we make. Up and down, that's it, you come up with the machine and scrub it out at the same time you're rinsing. If you start putting soap on the machine, you might use some haze or residue behind, you overuse the product. What this is doing is plus, later on when the floor looks like this, you probably might not need no chemical at all. Because this one produces soap with water that's inside the machine. Okay. So you fill it up to there, you have tier two, everything's gonna be catched to here. So you have about 14 gallons of cover.
Okay.
So you have to pre-sweep. This will prevent that tank. You don't want to be sticking your hand in there.
Okay.
Who knows what you picked up from it.
Uh-huh.
But after we're going to use it right now, we'll show you how to clean it, maintain it, and it just takes about 5 minutes.
Okay.
Just rinse it out, clean it out, take the brush off, rinse it out, squeegee. And just put this out, clean it out. This filter, sometimes it will get clogged up with lint, so pull it out, rinse it out, clean it out, and stick it back on. So what the purpose of this is, when the water is raising up, the pit pump always gets sucked up to the back door, so it will prevent any water from going into the back
door. Okay.
If you do use a pretty foamy cleaner, I recommend you to roll some of the foamer.
Okay.
So it can kill the foam. But make sure they always use with this on the machine. Now go to the back. If you have the squeegee assembly, so remember I told you that you can use all 4 inches of the squeegee blade before you just toss it. So no tools required. Screw this. Screw this mouth right here. And spring it. So now you can pull it off.
And then flip it over,
flip it over. So you can use basically all 4 edges. Once you start using the machine, you notice that you're leaving a lot of streak lines. Either your squeegee is dirty, and get a rag and just wipe it, or that means that your squeegees are already warm, so it's time for the filter. So no tools required. So everything you see that's yellow, those are your touching points. Like that little tray that's yellow, stops. Here, we have another clean out. So rinse it out, clean it out. These right here is where the squeegee mounts into that bracket. So when you're not using the machine, put the squeegee right here. So visually you can check, make sure you don't have a tear on your blade. Plus, you're not using it, don't have this hose like that. Letting me know that it's producing soap. If I press reset it, turn off the machine, turn it back on.
Okay.
If something goes wrong with the machine, this little triangle will lit up. See that?
Okay.
That's going to let you know there's something wrong with the machine. And plus these lights will blink individually, and then you can go to the troubleshooter and it will tell you what's actually wrong with the machine. It might, sometimes it might lit up this one or these two.
So this is a battery indicator, right?
That's the battery indicator that's going to let you know how much charge you still have on your machine.
Okay.
So these lights will start dissipating. This machine is a smart machine. It will use 80% of the charge. The 20% remaining will allow you, say you were back at the warehouse, to transport it to a charging station. The benefit that you have on the machine is that you have a built-in charger, so you can plug it anywhere, about 110 amps. Okay? But say you were scrubbing, had the head on the floor, it will stop scrubbing. It will still vacuum any water you had on the floor, but then that's letting you know, hey, I don't have enough torque or enough juice to torque that water. Alright? Any questions so far?
Pretty clear.
Really important on the batteries. This machine can run approximately from 3 to 4 hours on a full charge. So you need to do maintenance on these batteries, like kind of like on forklifts. You have to check the water level on each cell of the batteries. Not because I've opened this, it's gonna fill all the cells. Well, you have 6 cells on each battery. So basically when you do this, make sure you wear gloves and goggles, because that's acid. Okay, I'm just gonna open one right just to show you right now. See there, there's acid right there. So you have to use distilled water.
Distilled water.
You can get a gallon, and or they sell some little gallons. Oh, it's like a little gallon like this. It's made to fill batteries. It has like a little plunger in the end. You press, and fill. Once the battery, the cell's full, shuts off, and you can go to the next one.
Jose, can they get HydroLink for this?
They could get HydroLink for this. Later on.
I'll tell you about it afterwards. Yeah.
Yeah. So HydroLink, what it is we take all these caps off. We put a system that connect to each battery, and then you have like a little pump, and you get your gallon of distilled water, pump it, and it will fill it.
Oh, okay.
That's an option. Everything's protected by circuit breakers. Okay, on the batteries, if you need to put water on them, at least check them once a week.
Okay.
So if you use this machine every day, say you can turn it on Monday or Friday, somebody can double check. Water after you charge it, not before. Because if you overfilled it, you charge it, you're going to have acid. You know, it's always after.
Yeah, you know, right?
I know. Because I've been doing that with the forklift. You got to be full charged, because another, you're going to get it at the water.
Yeah.
Other than that, the same thing's going to happen. If it's low charge, what happens? You full charge, water's going to start pouring out of this.
Charging the battery, the battery will be cut. So if you fill it, that's it. We got a pass driver. And we got a brush for you guys.
Sorry, that's what we need, the brush.
Okay. See, this is the brush. Either you can use this or you can use that. This will last longer. Those you have to visually check, make sure you still have a pad. Sometimes pads do a little bit better job than a brush. So that's why I got you some pads. So once you start using the machine, you determine what you want.
Okay.
I got the brush and you got the pads. This is what I use last time I was here.
Yeah, I know.
Chemicals, paper towel dispensers, you name it, all that.
You know what, the only thing I don't see on this machine?
put the brush on for the pad driver,
it's magnetic.
Okay.
Where it has a magnetic head. So you just light it.
Oh, okay.
Remember all the yellow touching the brush there? Pops it out.
Cool. Okay, so you got the brush or the pad driver.
Yeah, that's good.
That's okay.
So now we want to start scrubbing. This is to increase pressure. Minimum 5, maximum 95 pounds of pressure. So last time I was here, I started with minimum pressure.
Jose, can you do that again? So
minimum 45, maximum 95 pounds.
Brush pressure.
Thank you. So obviously, if you always use it at 95, using a pad or a brush, you're gonna wear that brush quicker.
And your machine's not gonna run as long.
Yeah, and your machine's not gonna run as long.
So this pedal is to drop the head down. So you press, push out.
Like that.
Okay.
See? So you press, push out, and then you have like a little lift.